Hello guys, Wolf, say hello to everybody. We're in the mood, as you can see. He has his ball. Give me your ball. Outside it's hot, very hot. We are inside, we have air condition on. Once again, Wolf prefers the cold floor. Inside we have 23-22 degrees. Outside it's over 30. Is that right, Wolf? And the door is painted again. It will last a couple of weeks. So let's get here to our project. But before we start, let me tell you a couple of things. As you can see, I have covered the entire hull with the Seppeli wood strips, also the rear part at the stern. Here the Seppeli wood strips are vertical, and this is a piece that is going vertical like this in this axle, but it's going to be covered, so it doesn't make any difference. You won't be able to see it because the here is going to be a piece that the rudder will be tied, nailed, screwed on. So you can see that the endings of this and these wood strips are inside, and they're covered by these vertical wood strips, and it's smooth and looking perfect. Not my style of making a two layer, but okay, that's the kit. Now let me say a couple of more things, because today I was laughing and I could not stop. When you have a channel and make videos, any kind of videos, there are people that like your videos and people that don't like your videos. That's normal. If you're doing the things right and correct, then you can see that by the overall like in your channel. From our entire, all the videos that I have made, all the likes in total of almost 3 million views are 97%. So thank you very much, guys, for that. Probably you like what I'm doing. And then there's the other guys that do not like what they see. I don't understand why to watch something that you don't like. It's the right, of course, but in the last couple of weeks I'm laughing and I cannot stop, because as soon as I make a video public, there are 2, 3, 4 guys that waiting just to press the button to make them public and to press dislike. And I'm laughing. They think that they can ruin my mood. Go on, guys, continue like this. I'm laughing with what I can see, because you don't have a life. Get a life, guys, get a life. So enough about talking and doing an opening, and let's see what we have to do now. As you can see, I have made that part, also that part. This is the other side. I have sanded out everything. So what I need to do now is place these rubbing strakes. There are 3 rubbing strakes on each side. As you can see here, there's something in between the 2 rubbing strakes. Also here above, I have to place some extra pieces. I will worry about them later. So first I'm going to place the upper rubbing strake. Secondly, I'm going to place the lower rubbing strake, then I'm going to place this piece in between, and after I place this piece, I will place the middle rubbing strake, or I will see if I need to do some place up to here and continue from there. I will check it out during the construction. So, first of all, I have to place the upper and lower rubbing strake. This is, as you can see, very soft wood, so it's not going to be any trouble at all. Let me place the camera on a tripod and I'll get back to you. Now guys, I have just read the instructions and let's talk about it. The first rubbing strain is going to be at exactly this height. So, because it's very smooth and the planks are very well tied together, in some spots you cannot tell the difference between planks. Right here or here, I cannot see where the first plank ends and the other one starts. Also around here. So what I'm going to do now is make some measurements so I can have it correct. Also here I see I have, let me fix that. This happens. Be careful not to lose the piece. This happens. That's what you have as trouble when you have two layers planks. And now it doesn't seem to be able to glue it. Let me glue that and I'll get back to you. It's not glued yet, but the glue will dry, so no problem. What I was saying, I'm going to take some measurements here and I'm going to apply the measurements all the way. Of course, here I will take, I will consider this part too, and it will be great. So, let's see where we stand. Let's see what we need here. This will be exactly right here. All right. A little more that I need to. And here we start bending. Let me do some bending. It's very easy and I will do it fast and I'll get back to you. Let's place the first one. I will start here. Now, let's prepare to place the lower one. What we need to know here is this, the exact measurements, and we have them. The first one with the second one is 6 millimeters apart. So let's see now. 6 millimeters apart makes it almost probably at the middle of its gun port hole. This rubbing strake is 2 millimeters thick, so that makes 6 plus 2, 8, and the lower one is 12 millimeters apart, so we have 6 plus 2, 8 plus 12, 2 centimeters. It's not easy to hold it, so we have 2 centimeters. It's right here. Let me make the measurements in the entire hull, glue it, and I'll get back to you to show you the finished result. Now guys, let's move on. I have placed the two here. As you can see, it has a small curve to follow the hull where the, let's say, corner is. So this is normal. I will place first these planks that will go directly over here. Let me explain something to you. They will cover the part, this part here. I'm not going to place the rubbing strake just yet. I'm going to place it after I place this piece. I'm going to place it from this piece to the end and from this piece to the bow. I believe it's going to be easier. You can do it with every way you want. Like I always say, there's more than one way to do things. That doesn't mean that my way is wrong or the others are. So, the first plank goes directly here at this height. The last plank goes directly here at this height. So the in between must be at the exact position to match a small diagonal line. So I have the planks, softwood, it's 2x5 and in a length of 15 millimeters. Now, let's place the first one. The first one will go exactly like this. So, let's glue. I will probably need 4. If I need more, I will cut some extra. So, this is the first one. Some pressure, so it will glue. Here we have a small curve with this length. I'm not going to be able to bend it at all, so I'm going to use a little bit longer. I'm going to bend it and cut it in size. Let me bend it just a moment. Slightly, doesn't need much. Now only to find the adjusted position. Need some more. Right here, perfect. Now, the in-between. Definitely like this, so I will have to share its side. I will make it, let's see, yeah. And now the last plank won't fit, so I have to make it just, it fits, unbelievable good. Now, to make this thing straight, it's not going to be very hard. I like it. Now let me get the piece, cut it in size, and I'll get back to you to place the last one. Now guys, I have placed the two pieces in front at the bow. Now I'm going to place the final piece, and one side is almost done. I have some more pieces to place here vertically, and I will do that after I finish this. First of all, here we have an angle, you can see, so you have to cut it to a specific angle, you will make it fit. Make it fit. I need here to make it better. Now it fits. So, what seems easier to me is to glue the entire piece along the side of the hull, and then later to cut off all the pieces that are above the gun ports. That seems easier to me. Of course, you can do it with the way you choose. You can cut the pieces and glue them in position after. Then again, if you do that, you might have some issues with the lining because maybe the pieces are not aligned, but with this way they're definitely going to be aligned because it's a continue piece. Now let's glue. Pay much attention to glue it very well where the gun ports begin and end each gun port, because when you cut the piece and it's not glued well, it will unglue and might damage the hull because of the very thin sepal layer. So make sure that here everything is glued well. Now I'm going to cut open all the gun ports and I'll get back to you to place the rest of the side parts that goes above the top rubbing strake. So let me do that and I'll get back to you. This side is done. Of course I have to do the other side and still have to place some more pieces here. So let's do them together. To be honest with you, I haven't done any measurement because I believe let's continue and we'll do everything that is required. Now before placing any pieces, I have to place one piece like here and one piece here at the other corner. So let's cut it. It's very soft wood, so it's easy to cut. Of course, I will sand everything later. You can understand that. And also on the other side. Now, the four next pieces are going to be very, very easy to place, and we'll see about the rest. One goes here. The other goes there. Now, from here to here, I have to place a couple more pieces. Over here is the one. and also here. Now, let's see, from here to here, this part here I have to place 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces, 4, and from here to here I have to place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces. So, let me see if I can take some measurements and I'll get back to you. Now guys, here's an easy way to do it. Here we started measuring from the edge of the piece that I have entered. And as you see, according to the ruler, to the other edge, it's 10 centimeters. So it's easy to make the marks. I can make one every 2 centimeters. Let me do it like this, to be able to hold it. So every 2, here is one, here's another, here and here. So I have them equally divided. On the other side I will follow the same exact pattern, but let me see, I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 6. Here I have, if I use the same measurements exactly, I have almost 15. So I will take it from here. I have 14.5. And I will do the divide at 2.1, 4.2, 6.3, 18.4. I have 1, 2, 3, 4. I need 2 more. 20.5. And 23, 22.5. The last one will be smaller, 20.5 and 22.5. So got it. I will do it as before and I will show you the finishing result. So guys, this side is done, you can tell. It's looking beautiful, needs a lot of sanding of course. And as I can see, the drawings here at the top, I have to trim it so that the edge will end up here at the rail to become like a triangle. So this it won't going to be very hard, just some filing and accurate filing, not to destroy anything else. So I have to make the other side as well, do some sanding, do some sanding over here, and we are complete, at least at this point. And in our next video, I believe, since I can see the drawings, that we're going to work inside the deck, inside the rails. So thank you very much for being here with me, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and to those guys that unfortunately are not going to watch the entire video to hear that, just patience. Try not to hit the like or dislike button, probably dislike, before you watch the video. You might learn something. Thank you again, guys. See you soon.